Another action-packed edition of Sports Tonight has just kicked off from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. Always a delight to have you join us. I'm Austin Okonakwan. You know the deal. Sports Tonight, this is the playground for you. Whatever you want to talk about in your action-packed, racy-pacy world of sports. That's why this show is designed. We take a look at everything that is going down in our world of sports on the show tonight. We'll talk about the IWTF World Championships taking place in Düsseldorf, Germany. We'll have a Nigerian player standing by. We'll be talking to us tonight on the program. How is it going for Team Nigeria? We'll get you updates on that one tonight on the program. Also on the show, we'll set the record straight. I just got off social media. Ugly talks about a former ex-international passing away. That talk is so false. We'll be trying to establish connection with him tonight on the program. We're setting the record straight. We'll dissect the Super Eagles of Nigeria. They're getting ready for that friendly game against Togo. Who is in the list? Who is not supposed to be there? Who is there that deserves it? All of the talking points that comes out whenever a technical advisor releases a list, we'll talk about it tonight on the program. Just to bring you into everything that we're doing tonight on the program, I keep telling you that this show is designed for you. Don't just watch it. Come, let us play for the love of the game. You can be part of the program. Yes, you can. You can talk to us on Twitter, where channels_sports is a verified Twitter handle. What is it that you want to talk about? Just go to our Twitter handle, channels_sports, Facebook, channels-sports, and, you know, talk to us. Questions, comments, suggestions, whatever is going down in your world of sports, we want you to be part of the show tonight. Just to also let you know that all our top stories can be viewed on our website. It's channelstv.com and on YouTube.com/channelsweb. If you're on the go, you can download the Channels TV app for your iPad, your iPhone, your BlackBerry, your iOS, your Windows phones, and your Android phones. Just log on to m.channelstv.com, download the app, and you're part of everything that we're doing tonight on the program. Let's quickly bring the guys that will be talking to us in the studio. It's a Wednesday night. Joseph Mukuzi makes a return. Joseph, good to have you on the show.
Always a pleasure, I must say. Arsene Wenger getting a 2 years contract. we just hope that this will be eventful. I hope he will be assertive in the transfer market. Look forward to a great time with him.
Mixed reactions on social media. Some people like it. Others are like, no, not Wenger. But hey, the bot says Wenger is the man and he stays. Yeah. Sports editor from the Sporting Live, Oyewuchi Nwachukwu is also here. Oyewuchi, any proverbial angle from Wenger staying 2 more years at Arsenal?
No proverbial angle. You know, maybe Wenger is the cat with 9 lives. You know, I mean, just when everybody thought he was not going to win a trophy, that you know, he might live in disgrace, he won the FA Cup, and now he has been given a 2 years extension. So let's see how it goes. Maybe the guy has a way of navigating his way through crisis.
Who knows? So Arsene Wenger, that's the way the analyst chose to start the show tonight. Arsene Wenger staying on at Arsenal for another 2 years. A lot of reactions on social media. Guys, you guys are putting our social media handles on fire because of Wenger. But hey, Arsenal fans, keep them coming. That's it. It's all for the love of the game. Let's go to Düsseldorf in Germany now. That's the venue for the International Table Tennis Federation World Championships. We told you the story. Olajide Omotayo won his game yesterday. What happened to Olufunke Oshanaike? Remember, she defeated a 12-year-old table tennis player. She went on social media and said she's so pleased for that little girl and all she has achieved. She started playing table tennis at 6. Funke pushed her out of the way. But today, Olufunke Oshanaike campaign at the World Championships came to an end. What happened to her? She crashed out of round 128, losing out to world number 3, Miu Irano, 04. So that's the story. Olufunke Oshanaike, over 40, still going on strong. But when you meet the world number 3, you need to be really good to be that. You need to be either first or second in the world to be the world number 3. The Japanese dominated all the sets, winning 11-8, 11-2, 11-4, and 11-1 to tell Funke goodbye at the competition. But Onye, still positives for us. If you look at the World Championships and the talks that trailed before Team Nigeria started campaigning.
Yeah, Austin, if you want to really put it in the right perspective, I think Funke has been quite unlucky with the seeding at the World Championship. You remember, two years ago, she was seeded against the Olympic gold medalist at the World Champion. Her opponent today is the Asian champion, and she's the only one that has beaten the Chinese player. So at 40, you don't really expect Funke Oshinake to be, you know, at par with a player that is so fast, you know, and so fast. So I think for Oshinake, we have to commend, you know, her longevity, yep, what she's been able to do at this level at the World Championship. And, you know, it's high time we start, you know, as a country, to, you know, get players, younger players, players who could last, yeah, as Funke did, 20, 30 years, and play so well. Because putting so much responsibility on her shoulders, you know, sometimes may not all go well for her at this level.
Legendary moment of table tennis in Nigeria, right there for you to see. Olufunke Oshinake has been playing for this country since 1988. Wow, she started as a junior cadet player and now still playing at the World Championships at that competitive state. Hey, don't forget, she's current African champion.
That's true.
So that's it. Let's go to Düsseldorf, Germany. Olufunke Oshinake is standing by to put more perspective into this subject matter. Good evening, Funke. Welcome to the program.
It's nice to be on the panel. Good evening.
Okay, now where you're smiling, doesn't look like you lost the match today, but it's all good. Run us through what happened. You used experience to beat your opponent yesterday. She's just 12. What happened today? You didn't use anything?
No, I used everything. Even though I have injury because I actually cut my leg with a razor blade while I was doing pedicure. But that doesn't matter. I put in my best. I was actually scared from the beginning because this is a girl that actually won the Asian Championship. She defeated number one in China, number two, and number three. So for me, losing to her is nothing actually, and it's a wonderful privilege for me. And to get to the first round, the first 128, in fact, I'm so proud of myself at this age. So nothing to lose, my head is still up.
Nothing to lose for you, but bring all the table tennis players that are in Germany with you. Let's begin with Edem Ofiong. What can you say about her campaign?
Okay, actually, during the group event, she was not actually having an easy one. She lost out during the group event. She did her best, but unfortunately, she couldn't. You know, it's actually very, very hard, you know, playing without a coach. Most of the time, we need a coach here. She played without a coach, and she tried her best, but unfortunately, it was not enough. Then we have to talk about Jide Omotayo. I'm so very, very proud of that talented boy. He played wonderfully well. He impressed me. He's good. I think that is going to be for now our next Aruna Kadri. He is very, very good. He has this hunger for table tennis. He just wants to be the best, and he really, really, really impressed everybody here. And Segun Toriola lost to like number 25 in the world. He tried all his best too, but unfortunately, I think the guy was too fast than Segun Toriola. We played again this evening, doubles. We play again the European champion. I mean, Segun Toriola and Aruna Kadri. We're leading 2-0, but unfortunately, they came from behind and we lost 4-2. That was a very, very good match that actually we play on the center table. We lost, but it was very, very wonderful. So for now, I think the only person that is remaining right now is Haruno. And we are here to support him 101%.
I'm talking about Aruna Kadri. He wasted no time in beating his first opponent. So what you saw from that match, can Aruna power on at the World Championships?
I didn't hear that.
He won his first game. It was 4-0, straight up for him. And with what you saw watching Aruna Kadri, do you think he has what it takes to power on at the World Championships?
Oh my God, trust Aruna. All of us know Aruna. He's a fighter. He's a lion, you know. That was very, very easy, very easy match for him. You know, he just started. He didn't play any group event, you know, but playing like this today, actually, I was actually impressed. And he just started. He's going to play again tomorrow. As for me, I think Aruna is, if not semi-final, he's going to get to quarter-final. Though we have new table tennis board, we have new balls that's actually affecting a lot of us because we've been unable to train with the balls and the new table. You know, but I know with times, because he's complaining a lot too, but I know with time he's going to get used to it. And when he gets used to it, I trust Aruna. He's going to get there. He's getting there. But not to worry. We don't have coaches here, but we have the like of Segun Toriola. And we have one German coach that is trying to help us out here. But I know he's going to get to somewhere that is going to surprise Nigeria by the special grace of God.
Let's bring the discussion back home now. I talk about Table Tennis Administration. Are you aware that a new athlete representative has been elected for table tennis? If you know, what's your take on that?
I actually heard about it, and I wrote something on that. Somebody wrote something on that on Facebook, and I commented on it. I was very shocked, you know, because I think it is high time that most federations have to put somebody that can actually represent the athletes. Well, that's why they call it athlete representative, you know. I think we have the like of Segun Toriola, we have the like of me, even if they have to put Haruna, you know. But I don't understand what is going on in Nigeria. They said something went on, the guy came and they chose him, a guy that I believe that actually cannot actually take care of me or Segun Toriola or Haruna or Kodri or whatsoever. But something is being done, about it, because I think the guy that contested with him, they are having a protest, you know, and I believe something good is going to come out of it. But for me, I'm not actually impressed with it, because for table tennis, to come up, I think we have to start putting the best of the best. You understand? I mean, just like the last president, you understand? He's the best we could get, you know? And that is why right now that they want to put new, but we have to get the best people. They are telling me that, okay, at least representative is not going to do competition, but you have to represent me. Sometimes you have to go to some companies to talk to them that you want this thing for this athlete. You have to be bold enough, you know? And I think that's the kind of a person we want. But like I said, I don't live in Nigeria. There are a lot of things that they are doing in Nigeria that I'm not impressed. And I don't like people abusing me when I say my mind. They've been talking about it, that I don't want the young one to go. No, I want the young one to grow. Really, that's why I'm fighting for the young one. That's how I want to do more. But for somebody to represent the young ones or me, that person has to be able to sacrifice a lot for the sport. I have sacrificed a lot. Segun Toriola is sacrificing a lot. And we have a lot of people that are still sacrificing. And those are the people that we want on the board, you know. If they can do that, I'll be very happy. Mm. I love this sport and I don't want it to die. I want it to improve. I want it to be like the way it used to be when I first started. When we used to have almost every month a competition. We travel everywhere, competition, you know. But a lot of things is lacking right now. Just pray to Almighty God that something good is going to come out with this new body they are trying to form.
We can only wish table tennis in Nigeria all the best. Thank you so much, Olufunke Oshonaike, for everything you've done for table tennis in Nigeria. You need to go get some rest now. All the best in Germany.
Thank you for having me. I'm so tired. Thank you.
Thank you. So that's it. Experienced female table tennis player from Nigeria, Olufunke Oshonaike, giving us updates from the World Championships. And before we go on our first break, she made very, very good points. Mm. The need for us to play competitions. Now they are in Germany. She said new table tennis balls. New balls. You see? So everything will be new to if you've not been playing.
Very, very disturbing when she said that. I was just wondering, what did the federation do? What have they been doing? You can imagine new football and then it's not getting to the footballers on the field in Nigeria. It's quite unfortunate. These are things that ordinarily should have been introduced to the players a long time ago. They would have mastered it, and now they are in a world championship and they are using the balls for the first time, maybe training, and it will definitely affect their performance. It's quite sad.
I know. Oh yeah, I know you have a lot to say about this, and at some point, I'm like, if we throw this conversation to Chiwa Chukwuma, we're not going to leave here. But quickly, she made a lot of good points.
Yeah, I mean, I think the highlight of what she said was the athlete representative. Mm. Very important, yeah. Austin. You see, the athlete representative should be, you know, the first among equals. He should be the best. He should be somebody who can aggregate the interest of all table tennis players in this country. And what are they asking for? Mm. You know, the right environment.
That's right.
And they don't have it now.
You've mentioned two words, interest and right environment. Mm. We'll come back to this discussion. You're watching Sports Tonight on Channels Television. We'll go on a quick break now. When we come back, we will put an end to this silly talk going on social media. Tyler West, we're talking to us on the program. Don't go anywhere. Stay.